What if a simple compound found in coconut oil could disrupt some of the viruses tied to ME/CFS, long COVID, and fibromyalgia? Not in theory, but on a cellular level. Today we're breaking down the research on monolaurin and another lesser-known but equally important antiviral tool, L-Lysine. By the end of this video, you'll understand why I've taken both myself for years. Hi, I'm Dr. Courtney Craig, and I've lived with ME/CFS for over 25 years. I'm a clinician, nutritionist, and an educator. And I don't hype supplements. I rely on the evidence. Let's start with monolaurin. It's a monoglyceride made from lauric acid, one of the main fatty acids in coconut oil. But here's the thing. Monolaurin is not the same as coconut oil. When lauric acid is metabolized into monolaurin, its biological activity dramatically increases. This molecule can literally poke holes in the fatty membranes that protect certain viruses. Some viruses like Epstein-Barr, HHV6, RSV, and even SARS-CoV-2 have what's called a lipid envelope. It's a protective fatty shell. Monolaurin disrupts the envelope. It tears it open. The virus spills out, and what's left is cleared by our immune system. This can be seen under the microscope. In pigs infected with a coronavirus, monolaurin stopped replication and triggered the interferon pathway, one of our most critical antiviral defenses. You might be thinking, why haven't I heard this before? It's because human studies using monolaurin are still rare. Most clinical trials, strangely enough, have focused entirely on coconut oil, which unfortunately doesn't offer enough monolaurin to be therapeutic. You'd need to eat over 6 teaspoons of coconut oil just to get what's in one capsule of monolaurin. Gross and impractical. What has been studied is monolaurin in livestock animals, especially pigs, which are physiologically similar to humans, much more so than mice or rats. These studies show that monolaurin can reduce viral replication, improve gut barrier function, lower inflammation, and support a healthier gut microbiome. That's a lot for one molecule. And many of us with ME/CFS are dealing with chronic viral reactivations, especially EBV, HHV6, or CMV, cytomegalovirus. While antiviral drugs can help some, they often come with side effects and generally inconsistent results. That's where monolaurin comes in. It's broad spectrum. It doesn't disrupt your beneficial bacteria, and it targets viruses in a different way than prescription antivirals. This is why I've used it myself and recommend it to many others. If you're considering monolaurin, start slow. It's powerful, and for some, it can trigger a Herxheimer reaction, a die-off response that feels like a brief flu. A typical ramp-up protocol looks like this. Start with one capsule of monolaurin at 500 milligrams or so, and work your way up slowly to 4 per day. Now let's look at another antiviral tool that complements monolaurin, L-lysine. L-lysine is an amino acid your body needs to make proteins and immune cells, but we don't produce it on our own. We need to get it from food or supplements. Foods high in lysine include these. But lysine's benefits go beyond nutrition. It helps inhibit viral replication, especially in the herpes virus family. It does this by competing with another amino acid, arginine. So why does this matter? Viruses like HSV, EBV, and HHV6, all herpes family viruses, rely on arginine to replicate. Arginine helps them produce proteins and DNA, but lysine and arginine use the same transport channels to get into your cells. So when you have more lysine, you crowd out arginine, making it harder for the virus to replicate. This isn't just theoretical. Clinical research supports lysine supplementation for reducing herpes outbreaks, HSV1, and emerging evidence suggests it may also help with latent viruses that reactivate, like in ME/CFS and long COVID. Here's how to think about it. Lysine slows viral growth. Arginine fuels it. Keeping your lysine higher than arginine may help keep viral activity suppressed. So during viral flare-ups, consider increasing lysine-rich foods and limiting arginine-heavy foods. Here are some examples. For supplementation, typical doses range from 1,000 to 3,000 milligrams per day. Some trials use up to 6 grams per day safely, but long-term high doses are usually not recommended. This could negatively affect lysine and arginine balance. And while lysine is generally well tolerated, those with cardiovascular or gallbladder issues should check with a clinician before starting. Used together, monolaurin and L-lysine create a powerful 1-2 punch. Monolaurin disrupts the virus's protective membrane. Lysine makes it harder for the virus to replicate. This is why I include both in an antiviral protocol for ME/CFS, especially when viral reactivation is suspected. Low-grade fevers, flu-like symptoms, swollen lymph nodes. As always, none of these are cures, but they're evidence-informed tools that can help shift the balance in your favor. If you've tried L-lysine or monolaurin, let me know in the comments. What worked for you? If this was helpful, give it a like so more people can find it. And be sure to subscribe for more evidence-based content on supplements and recovery tools for post-viral illness. You can find the full blog post for monolaurin and L-lysine linked below, with more details and all the research citations. I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.